about the unit that attacked us in the mist? You knew something about them.
That wasn't my first run-in with them. It happened right before I was captured by the Soviets. We were on the Zero Line that day. The Afghan side. On our way back from training Mujahideen at a mountain camp in Kunar province. There's a lot of that work in Afghanistan. Most PFs shy away from it because it draws too much attention. But for us, that was the whole point. The job itself went great. We just had to make it back to a tribal area in Pakistan. But all of a sudden, visibility got real bad. It was no sandstorm. Our point man gave the strange report. He said he could see skulls in the mist.
Skulls?
The next moment he went silent. We scrambled into formation, right before his arms and legs came raining down on us. It was always supposed to be a dangerous mission, so I had Diamond Dog's very best with me. We were calling out to each other. But one by one, the voices just went dead. Whatever happened to me, I lost consciousness before I knew it. When I came to, I was in a Soviet camp, tied to an interrogation chair.
Could they be some new Spetsnaz unit?
No. The ones that interrogated me were just the average rank and file. Whatever group attacked us, the way they moved was just insane. And that mist, appearing out of nowhere. The Soviets don't have tech like that.
If they did, Ocelot would have heard about it.
I doubt the West does either. Otherwise, the folks at Langley would be sleeping a lot easier.
Why'd they come after you?
Wish I knew. I'm the only one who survived. Though I don't think they planned it that way. If I was their target, they wouldn't have just handed me over to the 40th Army. Whatever the case, we need to watch our step until we know who they really are. And boss, if you ever do run into them again, don't try to take them on. You just get the hell out of there. When I first started dealing with Zero, with Cypher, it was a somewhat parasitic relationship. Though, a mutually beneficial one. Cypher had no army of their own, so they wanted us. They wanted our strength. They approached me as a potential business partner.
But they had other motives.
Cypher coaxed us into Central America, into that US-Soviet proxy war, to fuel Mother Base's growth. Once we were big enough, they'd force us to join them. That was the plan.
That's where they had Paz, still Zeke.
Right. And if we refused, she would use Zeke to fire a nuke from Mother Base. The world would consider us a liability, and countries would unite to destroy us.
We stopped the launch.
And yet they still took us down, through that fake inspection they orchestrated to cover up their sabotage. That power Cypher wanted. We don't have it anymore. So why are they still after you? Is it just the fear of leaving you alive?
I don't know. Was Zero really... All I know is the man I knew wouldn't want this.
What do you mean?
We have to consider that it might not be Zero we're dealing with.
We know virtually nothing about Cypher anymore. How big they've gotten, what they want, or even who they really are. The new Mother Base started out as a test drilling rig operated by a mineral resources supplier, but their project fell through. The Seychelles government was happy to hand the place over to us. It was just scrap on stilts. So with a few dummy construction companies set up as fronts, we started renovating the half-finished rig. From the outside, it looked like the project was back on rails.
Kaz, you...
What?
I see what you're doing. Recreating the Mother Base we had 9 years ago. Only this time.
That's right. The Mother Base Cypher thought they destroyed will return from the grave to kill them. We'll prove to the world that we were the victors.
And if we lose again?
They can't fool us the same way twice. Now our enemies are in plain sight. And when our organization gets too big, we split it across companies. Any company that draws attention gets liquidated, and its capital is back-channeled into a new company. Most PFs are small-time operations anyway. And in this business, the minnows go bankrupt all the time. We've never aroused suspicion. Plus, we have Hewick.
Hewick?
Human Exploitation Company. It's a business specializing in intel gathering. Think of it as a civilian intelligence agency.
Cause that's...
Remember what they were trying to accomplish at the prison facility in Cuba? That gave me the idea. We dispatch moles into conflict zones around the world, and each sets up an intel network on site. Then they stay in place to give us stable points of contact when other nations intervene in the conflicts. Hewick's strength is that it has a cutout at each level. You get your job from one guy, then you hand it off to another. No one has direct access. It's a perfect black box. QAQ members also work their way into the superpowers' intelligence agencies to make sure Diamond Dogs gets work. We have those countries by the balls. That's our deterrent when we need it.
Networking? In the intelligence community?
Sure. That's how we've grown this far. And when you go out on missions, intel from Hewick will be there to back you up. But despite all that, Cypher has its eyes on us. The only reason I'm not dead is that they needed to know where you were. Figured if you woke up, I'd go straight to you.
That's why you made that ruckus at the Zero Line.
Yeah, to make their own surveillance work against them. I think it took some of the heat off Cypress.
Kaz.
Then I just had to wait for you to save me. And I've gotten used to waiting.
Kaz.
That's not all. It was a good chance to scout the market. And with the West wanting the Soviets out of Afghanistan, their agencies are bursting at the seams with funding. Boss, let's start by building up our Afghan presence.
Why put Mother Base in the Seychelles?
We're at the center of the world here.
We're all the way out in the Indian Ocean.
Come on. Lebanon, Sri Lanka, East Timor, and Africa. From here, our reach extends to conflict zones the world over, including Afghanistan, of course.
So it's prime real estate for a mercenary.
Exactly. Latin America isn't as close as I'd like, but we have Amanda and her people to help in that department. And besides, the Seychelles government owes us a favor.
Owes us?
The Seychelles has strong ties to the East, which the West wanted to shake up. It came to a head 3 years ago, in an attempted coup. It was a force of South African mercenaries, with US backing behind the scenes. They were only platoon size, but South Africa is home to some heavy PFs. Too much for the Seychelles to handle. In the end, they accepted help from the Tanzanian army, and quelled the coup. We set up the deal and handled on-site tactical instruction. That led to some training work for the Seychelles military. And when we put down a mutiny within their forces, well, we made a lot of people happy. They don't pay us. They just let us have a piece of their offshore territory on the promise we'll come running if something else happens.
So we're bodyguards, too.
It's a good setup. We can only take Mother Base so far here. We'll have to find somewhere else when this place starts getting big.
Aren't you being a little hasty?
Nothing hasty about it. You're back with us now.
So, Kaz, the ship that took us from Cyprus, it used to be a whaler.
Yeah, a Japanese vessel. How was the voyage?
It was... stimulating.
Well, she was part of a whaling fleet up until a few years ago. Her displacement isn't anything to write home about, but she can really move. She still had plenty of life left in her, but then the work dried up. Global opposition to whaling has been mounting for years.
Is that right?
The push to ban it has been gaining traction for a little over a decade. Individual species came under protection as the years went on. And then 2 years ago, the IWC adopted a moratorium on commercial whaling. Several countries, including Japan, fought it to the bitter end. But eventually, most whaling companies had no choice but to throw in the towel. You ever tried whale snake?
Can't say that I have.
When I was a kid in Japan, practically everybody ate it.
That good, huh?
The country was poor in those days, and whale was cheap. International opinions changed since then. In any case, that's why we were able to get a bargain price on the ship. Of course, we did end up spending 5 times the purchase price in modifications. We had to really work to fit in all the ESM and communications gear while keeping the whaler look intact. Right now, she's going around conducting SIGINT missions. In the future, we plan to use her as a communications relay base between you and Mother Base, and also as a chopper resupply vessel. Diamond Docks. The word diamond originally comes from the Greek adamas. It means indomitable, unyielding. Other words for the stones often mean eternal bond, fortitude, or purity. The same is true of the Star of Bethlehem flowers you laid on the boss's grave. They represent innocence, as well as chastity, yielding to no man while maintaining one's virtue. In other words, staying loyal to something.